Hello viewers, how are you? Today we are going to discuss about a rectilinear motion. Come to the case of this rectilinear motion. What is a rectilinear motion? Means if a body travels along the straight line. If a body travels along a straight line. According to mathematics, we can represent that if a body travels from one point to another point along the straight line, then we can represent it as rectilinear motion. So here the rectilinear motion can be in the form of horizontal, vertical and inclined form. It might be horizontal, vertical and inclined form. Come to the case here, if you consider that the body is moving a straight line, then you can observe that either the body can move in this direction or in this direction. The body can move in this direction or in this direction, or it can move towards the right or towards the left. In the same way, if you consider a vertical motion, the body can move in the upward direction or it can move in the downward direction. Can move in the downward direction. Whereas if you consider the inclined plane, whereas a body can travel down the inclined plane or up the inclined plane, up the inclined plane. In this way, here also that as we consider a body along the straight line, it has two directions. Either it moves in the forward direction or it moves in the backward direction. So based on that, we can represent that the motion has two directions. Motion has two directions. Motion has two directions. So now, based on that, here we had represented that any motion can be if we consider along a straight line, it has a two direction, either in the forward direction or in the backward direction. So here we can apply the sign conventions to this straight line motion. Suppose if we consider the body is moving towards the right as a positive, if we consider the body moving along the straight line as positive, then the body moving in the opposite direction is considered as negative.
If the body moving in the upward direction is considered as a positive, then the body moving in the downward direction is considered as a negative. In the same way, if the body moving down the inclined plane is considered as negative, then the body moving up the inclined plane is considered as a positive. By considering the body along a particular direction as a positive, then we can consider the body in the opposite direction as a negative, either in the case of horizontal, vertical or inclined plane. So here we can represent it based on the reference frame. We can represent the motion based on the reference frame. If we consider a straight line, whereas we had represented the origin at the center. If the body moves along this direction, positive x direction, then we represent it as a positive. Suppose if the body moves opposite to the origin, if the body moves along the negative x direction, then we represent it with the negative sign, positive and negative. Means based on the origin, if the body moves along the positive x-axis, then we represent it with the positive sign. And if the body moves in the negative x-axis, then we represent it with the negative sign. Based on this, we had applied this sign conventions to straight line motion along the horizontal, vertical and inclined plane. Whereas this straight line motion, it can be represented based on different equations. The first equation is x equals to t minus 2. X equals to t minus 2. Whereas we can also represent it as y equals to a sin omega t. Whereas we can also represent it as x equals to e to the power of alpha t. In this way, we can represent the equations in different forms. Straight line motion can be represented here. So here observe that x equals to t minus 2. Observe that the body is moving along the x-axis with respect to time. The body is moving along the x-axis with respect to time. Whereas observe this equation, y equals to a sin omega t. The body is moving along the y-axis with respect to time. As you observe this, x equals to e to the power of alpha t. Here, the body is moving along the x-axis with respect to. In this way, we can represent the rectilinear motion equations. The rectilinear motion can be represented based on position, velocity, and acceleration. Where the position is represented as r bar and the velocity is represented as v bar and acceleration is represented as a bar. So here we know that velocity v bar is equals to dr by dt. V bar equals to dr by dt. And here the acceleration is represented as a bar equals to dv bar by dt. Dv bar by So here we had represented the velocity in terms of position, rate of change of displacement, and acceleration is represented as rate of change of velocity, or the time rate of position as well as the time rate of velocity can be represented as here by using these equations. So come to the case, here we had represented velocity as well as acceleration. Now based on this, now we are going to discuss. After that, the acceleration is given as a bar equals to dv bar by dt. A bar equals to dv bar by dt, where v bar equals to dr by dt. So here we are just going to consider the magnitude, so we are neglecting the direction. So here a equals to dv by dt, where if we substitute v equals to dr by dt, then the equation can be represented as d square r by dt. Dd square r by dt square. It represents the case of acceleration in terms of displacement. In terms of the displacement. Now here, we are going to represent another equation for this acceleration. Here, assume that a is equal to dv by dt. A equals to dv by dt. I am going to multiply change in the position and divide with the change in the position. So now here, as you observe this, a is equal to dv by ds into ds by dt. Ds by dt. So here, observe that rate of change of displacement or time rate of displacement is nothing but velocity. Then we can represent it as a equals to v into dv by ds. A equals to v into dv by ds. Based on that, we can write it as, if we cross multiply this, we have a into ds is equals to v into dv. So this shows the relation between acceleration and velocity. Based on the displacement, change in the displacement as well as a change in the velocity. So here, let us consider the equation. If a body is moving along the straight, then we are going to represent the AS case based on the equation x equals to t minus 2, which we had seen earlier. So here we have to consider the time. So the body has started at t equals to 0 seconds and it has moved to the other end up to t is equals to 3 seconds. T equals to 3 seconds. So here now we have to represent the displacement for this. Let us consider t is equals to 0 second. T equals to 0 second. If we substitute here, we get a displacement or the position x equals to 0 minus 2. Nothing but a minus 2 meter. So here the body is at a minus 2 meters. Minus 2. So here at t is equals to 1 second. Here if we substitute here, we have 1 minus 2 is nothing but minus 1. Minus 1. So here the body will be at a minus 1. After that, if you consider t is equals to 2 seconds, then x is equals to 2 minus 2, it will be 0. Means the body has attained the position of 0. The body has attained the position of 0. At t equals to 3 seconds. At t equals to 3 seconds, we have x equals to 3 minus 2. Then we get a So here the body has reached to the position 1. So in this case, now we have to consider the displacement as positive or negative. So here also that initially the body is on the negative side of the ocean. Since it is moving towards the positive. Since the body is moving towards the positive, we consider this displacement or the position as positive. We don't consider it as negative. Why? Because it is increase. It is not a decrease. The position is not a decrease. It is in the mode of increase. That's why we consider it as a positive. Let us find out the velocity for this path which we have seen earlier. Let us consider the equation. We have seen that x equals to t minus 1. X equals to t minus 1. So here we know that v is equals to dx by dt. V equals to dx by dt. So here if we differentiate this equation, then here we get a dx d of dt into t minus 2. Why? Because I substitute x equals to t minus 2. Then if we substitute here, we know that dt by dt is nothing but 1. And then minus d by dt of a constant. We know that differentiation of constant is 0. So here we get v is equals to 1 meter per second. So here we had represented the velocity. Observe that the velocity is constant. Then automatically the acceleration of the body moving along the straight line will be 0. In this case, the acceleration is 0. Suppose if we write the equation as x equals to 2 minus t, x equals to 2 minus t, then the velocity is given as v equals to dx by dt equals to d by dt of 2 minus t, d by dt of 2 minus t. So here also that d by dt of 2 minus d by dt of. So here we know that a differentiation of constant is 0 minus dt by dt gets cancelled. So we get a minus 1. So now the velocity is minus 1 meter per second. And its acceleration is a equals to dv by dt equals to 0. Why? Because it is constant. Minus 1 is a constant. So here we get an acceleration a equals to 0 meter per second. So here based on that, when the body is moving along the straight line, its acceleration is 0. It moves with constant velocity. It moves with a constant velocity. Now we are going to discuss about motion in one dimension. Commonly the motion in the one dimension is represented as two forms. One is uniform motion and one is a non-uniform motion. Means when we consider uniform motion and when we consider non-uniform motion, means when the velocity is constant. Velocity is a constant, then we can consider it as a uniform motion. And here in this case, the acceleration is equals to 0. In this case, when the velocity is constant, the acceleration is equals to 0. Then we can consider it as a uniform motion. Whereas in the case of non-uniform motion, velocity is not equals to constant. Means here the acceleration is not equals to 0. Then we can consider non-uniform motion. So here this non-uniform motion, again it is being classified into two types. The first one is uniformly accelerated motion. And second one is non-uniformly accelerated motion. In the case of uniformly accelerated motion, the acceleration remains constant. Whereas in the case of this non-uniformly accelerated motion, acceleration is not a constant. It varies. In the case of uniformly accelerated motion, since we had considered acceleration as constant, we apply the kinematic equations such as v equals to u plus at, v square minus u square equals to 2as, and s equals to ut plus half a d square. Whereas in the case of non-uniformly accelerated motion, here acceleration is not constant. So here we consider the equations as a is equals to dv by dt and v is equals to ds by dt, and a into ds is equal to v into dv. We consider this equation. As you consider this first equation, we can represent that acceleration is a function of time. this equation can be represented as a acceleration is function of a time. Whereas if we consider the second equation, here we can represent that velocity is a function of time. Velocity is a function of time. Whereas here also that the acceleration is a function of a displacement. So in order to solve the problems, we are going to see some differential and integral equations which we come across. So these are common equations where we can find in the case of these physics problems. Very common equations. So in here, what is meant by differentiation and what is meant by integration? See, in the case of differentiation, the power of the power has been decreased by 1. The power has been decreased by 1. Whereas in the case of integration, the power has been increased by 1. The power has been increased by 1. After that, differentiation of x to the power of n. Here, after that, the x possesses a power of n. So, when we differentiate this equation, the power present to the x has been brought in front of the x. And the power present to the x has been reduced by 1. So after that, d by dx of x to the power of n can be written as n into x to the power of n minus 1. N into x to the power of n minus 1. Whereas if we differentiate a constant, so here if we consider it as a k, if we differentiate a constant, the differentiation of constant is 0. So here differentiation, if we differentiate a sin theta, d by dx of sin theta is cos theta. And here differentiation of cos theta is minus sin theta. And if we differentiate exponential, again we will get the exponential term. There is no change in the case of this exponential. But in front of this exponential, suppose if we consider that exponential possesses 2x. Instead of x, if it possesses 2x, then we can write it as 2 into e to the power of 2x. Why? Because we have to differentiate this 2x also. Then, here the 2 will come in front of this exponential. Suppose if we consider e to the power of nx, e to the power of nx, then a differentiation of e to the power of nx is n into e to the power of nx, n into e to the power of nx. In this way, we can represent the exponentials. So here, come to the case of integration. After that, in the case of differentiation, differentiation of sin theta is constant. Whereas in the case of integration of sin theta is minus cos theta. Integration of sin theta is minus cos theta. Whereas integration of cos theta is sin theta. And here after that differentiation of cos theta is minus sin theta. And here after that the cos theta, integration of cos theta is sin theta. Whereas in the case of integration, if power is being integrated, here then the power increases by 1. After that integration of x to the power of n into dx is equal to x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1. Whereas if we integrate exponential, then here we get e to the power of x. Suppose if we integrate 1 by x in 1 by x, then we get log x, l n x. Since this log x possesses exponential term, it can be represented in terms of log base n, and it can be represented as 2.3026 log base n. In this way, we can represent this equation 2.302x. Exponential term has been converted into base term. Base term. In this way, we consider this a problem based on this analysis. If x equals to alpha t square minus beta t cube, then find time when acceleration is 0. When acceleration is 0, where alpha and beta are constants here. Here, alpha and beta are constants. Based on these constants, here now we have to find time. We have to find the time when acceleration is 0. So here, given that acceleration is equal to 0. So here, in order to find this, let us find out the velocity. Based on it, we know that v is equal to dx by dt. V equals to dx by dt. Then if we substitute here, we have d by dt of alpha t square minus beta t cube. Beta t. So here, separate. If we split this, we have d by dt of alpha t square minus d by dt of beta t cube. Beta t cube. So here we know that alpha and beta are constant. So we can bring outside. We can bring them outside. Then we can write it as d by dt of t square minus beta into d by dt of t cube. D by dt of t cube. So here observe that in the case of differentiation, power decreases by 1. Then we can write it as alpha into 2 into t to the power of 2 minus 1. Nothing but t. Minus beta into d by dt of t cube. Nothing but 3t square. Why? Because the power has been decreased by 1. So here we got alpha into 2t minus beta into dt cube. So now we have to find acceleration by using this equation, where acceleration is given as a equals to dv by dt, dv by dt. Now we have to substitute the value of velocity in this equation. Then we can write it as d by dt of 2 alpha t minus 3 beta t square. 3 beta t square. So here we know that 2 alpha is constant, so we can bring it outside into dt by dt minus 3 beta is constant, so we can bring them outside. 3 beta into d by dt of t square. So here dt and dt gets cancelled, so we have a is equals to 2 alpha minus 3 beta into t square, nothing but 2t. 3 beta into 2t. So here we got acceleration as a equals to 2 alpha minus 6 beta t. 2 alpha minus 6 beta. So now we have to find the time when acceleration is 0. So here we substitute a equals to 0. 0 equals to 2 alpha minus 6 beta t. From this we have 6 beta t is equals to 2 alpha. So here 2, 3 is 6. So here based on that we can write it as t is equals to alpha by 3 beta. This represents the time in this case. The next problem is the acceleration of a particle starting from rest varies with time according to the relation a equals to alpha t plus beta. A equals to alpha t plus beta. Find velocity after time t. Now based on this acceleration we have to find the velocity. So now initially we have to represent the relation between the acceleration and the velocity as a equals to dv by dt. You know that a equals to dv by dt. From this equation we have dv is equals to a into dt. Dv equals to a into dt. So here now we have to integrate this equation. Integration of dv is equals to integration of a into dt. Integration of a into dt. So now we have to find this velocity after time t. Means it has started from origin. Then we can represent it as integral of 0 to b is equals to integral of 0 to t a into b, where a equals to alpha t plus beta. Here alpha and beta are constants. Alpha and beta are constants. So based on these constants we have to represent the equation. So if we substitute the value of a in this equation, we have integration of dv is v within the limits 0 to v is equals to integration of 0 to t alpha t plus beta into dt. Alpha t plus beta into dt. We know that the first initial we have to substitute the upper limit. Of minus we have to substitute the lower limit. Based on that if we substitute the limits we have v minus 0 is equals to integration of 0 to t alpha t into dt plus, I'm splitting this integration, we have integration of 0 to t beta into dt. So here observe that we know that in the case of integration the power has to be increased by 1. Means here we have power as 1, then 1 plus 1 we will get a 2. Then based on that v, t into dt can be represented as alpha into t t square by 2 within the limits of 0 to t plus beta into dt is nothing but t within the limits of 0 to t. So on substituting the limits here we get v is equals to alpha t square by 2 plus beta. It represents the velocity after time. Our next problem is if velocity v is equals to 3d square plus 2d, then find the value of x at a time of 0 to 2 seconds. So we have to find the velocity in between this time limit 0 to 2 seconds. In order to find this, let us consider the initial time as 0 seconds and final time as 2 seconds. So now based on this, now we have to find the value of x, nothing but a displacement. We have to find the displacement. So in order to find this displacement, here we consider the equation of velocity. We know that v is equal to dx by dt. V equals to dx by dt. So here if we cross multiply this equation, we have dx is equal to v into d. Dx equals to v into d. On integrate this equation, we have integration of dx is equal to integration of v into dt. So here also that we have to find the displacement. So initial displacement is 0 and the final displacement is x. And here the initial time is 0 and it has reached to 2 seconds. The time is 2 seconds. Based on this, now we have to find the equation. Well, we know that integration of dx is x within the limits 0 to x v equals to, where we know the value of v as integration of 0 to t 3t square plus 2t into dt. So now in order to integrate this equation, we have to split this. So on splitting, observe that before going to split this, observe that integration of dx is x. We have to substitute upper limit minus lower limit. The upper limit is x and the lower limit is 0 minus 0. X minus 0 equals to integration of 0 to t, sorry, to 3t square dt. 3d square dt minus integration of 0 to 2, 2t into dt. 2t into So here we know that t square dt can be represented as t cube by 3. Why? Because the power is being raised by 1. Then we can write it as x minus 0 is x. X equals to 3 into t cube by 3 within the limits 0 to 2 minus 2t into dt. Here the power is 1. It has to be raised by 1. Then it can be represented as 2 into t square by 2 within the limits 0 to 2. 0 to 2. So here then it can be represented as x equals to 3 and 3 gets cancelled and 2 and 2 gets cancelled. We have t cube within the limits 0 to 2 minus t square within the limits 0 to 2. T square 0 to 2. So here if we substitute, we have x equals to 2 cube minus 0, upper limit minus lower limit, minus upper limit is nothing but 2 square minus lower limit, 2 square. So here we know that 2 cube is nothing but 8, 2 into 2 into 2, nothing but 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. So we can be represented as 8 minus 0 minus 2 square is 4 minus into minus plus 0. So here we get x equals 8 minus 4, nothing but 4 meters. Nothing but 4 meters. The next problem is the relation between time and distance is t equals to alpha x square plus beta x, where alpha and beta are constants. Find retardation. Here we have to find the retardation. In order to find this, the equation is given as t is equal to alpha x square plus beta x. Whereas here he had given that alpha and beta are constants. Alpha and beta are constants. So he had given that alpha and beta are concept. So based on this, now we have to find the retardation. We have to find the retardation. In order to find this, what we do is we differentiate this equation with respect to displacement. dt by dx is equal to d by dx of alpha x square plus beta x. Alpha x square plus beta x. So here based on this, dt by dx is equal to d by dx of alpha x square plus d by dx of beta x. D by dx of beta x. So here based on that, d by dx is equal to d by dx of alpha x square. It can be represented as alpha into 2x. Alpha into 2x. Why? Because that the power is being decreased by 1. Then plus d by dx of x is nothing but 1. Because dx by dx gets cancelled, so again we will get 1. So dt by dx equals to alpha into 2x in plus beta. Where we know that v is equals to dx by dt. V equals to dx by dt. So if you make this reciprocal, then we can write it as 1 by v equals to dt by dx. So in the place of dt by dx, we can substitute 1 by v. Based on that, we can write it as 1 by v is equals to 2 alpha x plus beta. 2 alpha x plus beta. Or we can also write this equation as v is equal to 1 by 2 alpha x plus beta. V equals to 1 by 2 alpha x plus beta. We can also write this equation as v equals to 2 alpha x plus beta whole to the power of minus 1. 2 alpha x plus beta whole to the power of minus 1. So based on this equation, now we have to find the acceleration. Where acceleration a is given as a equals to dv by dt. dv by dt. So in order to find this, what we do is we just multiply and divide it with the displacement dx by dx. Then we can write the equation as a equals to dv by dx into dx by dt. dx by dt. Where dx by dt is nothing but velocity. So this equation can be represented as v into dv by dx. V into dv by dx. Now we have to substitute the value of v here. We have to substitute the value of v. On substituting here, we get a is equal to 2 alpha x plus beta over to the power of minus 1 into d by dx of 2 alpha x plus beta whole to the power of minus 1. Whole to the power of minus 1. Now we have to find the differentiation of this 2 alpha x plus beta. So here differentiation of dx, d by dx of 2 alpha x plus beta whole to the power of minus 1. Come to the case of this. Here minus 1. So 2 alpha x plus beta whole to the power of minus 1. So here first what we do is we just do the differentiation for this power. We do differentiation for this power. So here in the case of differentiation, you know that the power decreases by minus 1. Then we can write it as 2 alpha x plus beta. Already we have minus 1. And then we have to represent minus 1 in front of this. And minus 1 minus 1 minus 2. Minus 2. After increasing that power, now we have to differentiate this 2 alpha x. Why? Because here x is present, so we have to differentiate. Where here in front of beta, we don't have any x value. So the differentiation of constant is 0. So now we have to differentiate this 2 alpha x. When we differentiate this 2 alpha x, we get a 2 alpha. So here d by dx of 2 alpha x plus beta over to the power of minus 1 is minus 2 alpha into 2 alpha x plus beta whole to the power of minus 2. Minus 2. So by substituting this value, here we get acceleration a is equal to 2 alpha x plus beta whole to the power of minus 1 into minus 2 alpha into 2 alpha x plus beta whole to the power of minus 2. So this 2 alpha x plus beta whole to the power of minus 1 is here, and here we have 2 alpha x plus beta whole to the power of minus 2. Since the bases are same, v we can add the power, then we can write it as A equals to minus 2 alpha into 2 alpha x plus beta whole to the power of minus 1 minus 2, nothing but minus 3. Then we can represent it as A equals to minus 2 alpha by 2 alpha x plus beta whole cube. Why? Because I brought this numerator into denominator. So the power sign has been changed. Power sign has been changed. Where it can be represented as A equals to minus 2 alpha by 2 alpha x plus beta whole cube. Where we know that here V is equals to 1 by 2 alpha x plus beta. Then based on that, we can write it as A equals to minus 2 alpha into. Here 1 by 2 alpha x plus beta is nothing but V. So V to the power of 3. V, this is the answer. Next problem is, the acceleration of a particle is given by A is equals to 3t square plus 2t plus 2. Where t is the time, if the particle starts out with a velocity, u is equals to 2 meter per second, at t is equals to 0, What is the velocity of the particle? At the end of 2 seconds, t is equals to 2 seconds. So here, based on this time, now we have to represent the velocity, final velocity. So in order to represent that, the acceleration is given as A equals to 3t square plus 2t plus 2. A equals to 3t square plus 2t plus 2. In order to find this, we know that A is equals to dv by dt. A equals to dv by dt. On cross multiplying this equation, we have dv is equals to A into dt. dv equals to A into dt. Now we have to integrate this equation. Integration of dv is equals to integration of A into dt. So here, come to the case. The velocity has been changed from 2 to v. Why? Because we have to find the final velocity. So initial velocity is represented as 2. And the final velocity. Here the time has been changed from 0 to 2. So here integration of dv is nothing but here v within the limits 2 to v. Which is equals, where we know the value of A as integration of 0 to 2, 3t square plus 2t plus 2 into dt. So now, separate the integration. On separating this integration, we have V minus 2. I'm substituting the limits. Upper limit minus lower limit. V minus 2 is equals to, V minus 2 equals to integration of 0 to t. 3t square into dt plus integration of 0 to 2. 2t into dt plus integration of 0 to 2. 2 into dt. So here, based on this, we can write it as v minus 2 is equal to integration of 3t square. Power is being increased, raised by 1. Then it can be represented as 3 into t cube by 3. Within the limits 0 to 2 plus 2 into power is being raised by 1. Here the power is 1. 1 plus 1, 2. So we can write it as t square by 2 within the limits 0 to 2 plus 2 into integration of dt is t within the limits 0 to 2. So here v minus 2. Here 3 and 3 gets cancelled. 2 and 2 gets cancelled. So we have t cube within the limits 0 to 2 plus t square within the limits 0 to 2 plus 2 t within the limits 0 to 2. So here t cube is nothing but v minus 2 is 2 cube minus 0. And substituting the limits we get 2 cube minus 0 plus, and substituting the limits we have 2 square minus 0 plus 2 into, and substituting the limits here we have 2 minus 0. So here we have V minus 2 is equal to 2 cube is nothing but 8. 8 minus 0 is 8. Plus 2 square, nothing but 4. 4 minus 0 is 4 plus 2 into 2, 4. So here after that V minus 2 equals to 8 plus 4, 8 plus 8, nothing but 16. V minus 2 equals to 16. Then we have V is equals to 16 plus 2, nothing but 18 meter per second.
The next problem is that starting from rest, acceleration of a particle is a equals to 3 into t minus 1. A equals to 3 into t minus 1. What is the velocity at t equals to 4 seconds? At t equals to 4 seconds. So based on this acceleration equation, we have to find the velocity at time t equals to 4 seconds. In order to find this, the acceleration is given as a equals to 3 into t minus 1. In order to solve this, already we had seen that A is equals to dv by dt. A equals to dv by dt. So based on this, dv is equals to A into dt. Dv equals to A into dt. Then integrating this equation on both sides, integration of dv equals to integration of A into dt. So here we have to find the velocity. Whereas let us consider the initial velocity as 0 and the final velocity as a v, and the time has been changed from 0 to 4 seconds. 0 to 4 seconds. Why? Because we have to find the velocity at t equals 4 seconds. So here integration of dv is nothing but v within the limits 0 to v, which is equals to integration of 0 to 4. The value of a is 3 into t minus 1 into dt. 3 into t minus 1 into dt. Upper limit minus lower limit represents v minus 0 is equals to 3 is constant. So we can write it outside. Integration of 0 to 4 t into dt minus integration of 0 to 4 dt. So here on integrating this equation, here we get v is equals to 3 into integrate power will be raised by 1, then it can be represented as t square by 2 within the limits 0 to 4 minus integration of dt is t within the limits 0 to 4. So here observe this, v is equals to 3 into t square, nothing but 4 square by 2. So here lower limit is 0 minus upper limit is 4, lower limit is 0. So here based on that, it can be represented as v equals to 3 into 4 square is nothing but 16 by 2 minus 4. 16 by 2 minus 4. So based on that, we can write it as 3 into. So here a 2 is 16, 8 minus 4. Then we can write it as 3 into 4, which is equals to 12 meter per second. This is the next problem is given x equals to 2 minus 5t plus 6t square. What is initial velocity of the particle? We have to find the initial velocity based on this displacement. In order to find this, first of all, we have to derive the equation for velocity. Based on the equation, v is equals to dx by dt. Then we can write it as d by dt of 2 minus 5t plus 6t square. 2 minus 5t plus 6t square. So here, d by dt of 2 minus d by dt of 5t plus d by dt of 6t square. I am splitting this differentiation with respect to the equation. Differentiation of constant is 0, and here we get v. V is equals to 0 minus d by dt of 5t, nothing but 5, plus d by dt of 6t square. Power will be decreased by 1. 6 into 2, 12t. So now we have to find the initial velocity. The initial velocity is represented when the time t is equals to 0 seconds. So here if we substitute the value of t as 0, we have t is equals to 0 minus 5 plus 12 into 0, nothing but v is equals to minus 5 meter per second. Velocity of the particle is given by v is equals to 180 minus 16x whole to the power of 1 by 2. Find the acceleration of the particle. Find the acceleration of the particle. Observe that the velocity is given as 180 minus 16x whole to the power of 1 by 2. In order to find this, we represent the equation in terms of acceleration as a is equals to dv by dt. A equals to dv by dt. Now we are going to multiply and divide with the change in the displacement dx. So here, based on that, the equation can be represented as a equals to dv by dx into dx by dt. Dx by dt. So here we know that dx by dt is nothing but v. So the acceleration is represented as a equals to dv by dx. Dv by dx. So here, now based on this equation, now we have to find the acceleration based on this velocity. Now we have to substitute this value. Here if we substitute, we have a is equals to, the value of v is 180 minus 16x whole to the power of 1 by 2. Whole to the power of 1 by 2 into d by dx of 180 minus 16x whole to the power of 1 by 2. 180 minus 16x whole to the power of 1 by 2. So, but now we have to differentiate this equation. We have to differentiate this equation. So, let us differentiate this. So, here after that d by dx of 180 minus 16x whole to the power of 1 by 2. First, we have to differentiate the power. Then it can be represented as 1 by 2 into 180 minus 180 minus 16x whole to the power of 1 by 2 minus 1, nothing but minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2. Now we have to differentiate this 16x. On differentiating this 16x, here we get minus 16, minus 16. Observe that 2 is 16, I 2 is 16. So here, on differentiating this d by dx of 180 minus 16x whole to the power of 1 by 2, we get a minus 8 into 180 minus 16x whole to the power of minus 1 by 2. It can also be written as minus 8 by 180 minus 16x whole to the power of 1 by 2. Now substitute this value in this equation. On substituting here, we have a equals to 180 minus 16x whole to the power of 1 by 2 into minus 8 by 180 minus 16x whole to the power of 1 by 2. Observe that 180 minus 16x whole to the power of 1 by 2 gets cancelled. Why? Because it is in numerator and denominator. Then the acceleration is represented as a equals to minus 8 meter per second square. Our next problem is an object moving with a speed of 2.25 meter per second. 2.25 meter per second is decelerated at a rate given by dv by dt is equals to minus 1.5 root v, where v is instantaneous speed. Find the time taken by the object to come to rest position. Find the time taken by the object to come to rest position. In order to represent this, we consider rate of velocity, time rate of velocity, and it is given as dv by dt equals to minus 1.5 root v, minus 1.5 root v. So here, if we bring this root v towards this side and send this dt towards this side, then we have dv by root v is equals to minus 1.5 dt. Minus 1.5 dt. So here, as you observe that root v can be taken up, then we can write it as v to the power of minus 1 by 2 into dv is equals to minus 1.5 dt. Minus 1.5 dt. So now let us integrate this equation on both sides. We have integration of v to the power of 1 by 2 into dv is equals to minus integration of 1.5 into dt. Now we have to apply the limits. Observe that the velocity has been decreased from 2.25 to 0. So I am going to represent it as 2.25 to 0 within a time of 0 to t. 0 to 40. So here v to the power of minus 1 by 2 into dt can be, observe that the power has to be raised by 1, minus 1 by 2 plus 1, nothing but 1 by 2. So here it can be represented as v to the power of 1 by 2 by 1 by 2 within the limits 2.25 to 0, which is equals to minus 1.5 into dt is nothing but t within the limits 0 to t. And substitute. So here 1 by 1 by 2, nothing but it can be represented as 2. 2 into v to the power of 1 by 2 within the limits 2.25 to 0 equals to minus 1.5 into t, and substituting the limits. Why? Because upper limit minus lower limit. T minus 0, nothing but T. So here now I am going to substitute the limits. 2 into V to the power of 1 by 2. 0 minus 2.25 hold to the power of 1 by 2. Equals to minus 1.5 T. So here based on this we can write it as 2 into minus 2.25 hold to the power of 1 by 2 hold to the power of 1 by 2 equals minus 1.5 into t. Minus and minus gets cancelled. And here 2.25, root of 2.25 can be represented as 1.5. 1.5 is equal to 1.5 into t. 1.5 and 1.5 gets cancelled. We have t is equal to 2 seconds. The time taken is 2 seconds in order to come to rest position. The next problem is a particle is located at x equals to 0 at a time t equals to 0 starts moving along a positive x direction with velocity varies as v equals to alpha into root x. V equals to alpha into root x. The displacement varies with the time, as we have to find the displacement with respect to time. How does it vary? In order to derive, we consider the velocity equation where v is equals to alpha into root x. Alpha into root x, where alpha is constant, v is velocity, and root x is displacement. Now we are going to v is equals to by dt. V equals to dx by dt. So if we substitute here, we have dx by dt is equals to alpha into root x. Alpha into root x. So here based on this, dx by root x is equals to alpha into dt. Dx by root x equals alpha into dt. Then based on that, if you bring this root x upward, we have x to the power of minus 1 by 2 into dx is equals to alpha into dt. Now we have to integrate this equation. Integration of x to the power of minus 1 by 2 into dx is equals to integration of alpha into dt. Initially the displacement is considered as 0. And the final displacement will be x. Initial time is 0 and the final time is t. So here based on this, on integrating this equation, we know that in the case of integration, the power is being raised by 1. Then we can write it as x to the power of 1 by 2 by 1 by 2 within the limits 0 to x. Whereas it is equals to alpha into integration of dt is t within the limits 0 to t. So here 1 by 1 by 2, it can be represented as 2. 2 into x to the power of 1 by 2 and substituting the limits. Why? Because x minus 0, nothing but x is equals to alpha t. So now let us square this equation. Square this equation both sides. On squaring this equation, here what happens is we can write it as 4x is equals to alpha square into t square. 4x square equals alpha square into t square. Then x equals to alpha square by 4 into t square. Observe that alpha is constant as well as 4 is constant. Based on that, we can represent that directly proportional to t square. Means the displacement is directly proportional to time square. Displacement is directly proportional to time square.